how do Bitcoin miners mine?
There's no actual digging involved. Think back to our video on hashing. So a hash function takes a message of any length and returns a fixed length hash, which hopefully looks quite random. Right. So if you change even a little bit of your message, the whole hash changes. So this is how Bitcoin mining works, right? In brief. So we have a block, and at the top of the block is the hash of the previous block and a number, right, which we're going to call our nonce. This is a number we're making up. Let's start at one and go up. And then here we've got all the transactions, so tip transactions, one of which will give me some Bitcoins because I'm the miner. The way this works is I start with a random number here, and then I hash this entire thing, and I get a hash out the bottom here. To mine successfully, this hash needs to be very, very small. So let's say, for example, it has 10 leading zeros, right, as an example. If I successfully pick a number where when I hash this entire thing, including the number, it has 10 leading zeros, I've successfully mined that Bitcoin. Right. Now that's quite unlikely. You've got to think that each zero and one has a roughly 50% chance of being a one. So to get one leading zero, it's going to be about 50% of the time. Two leading zeros, about 25% of the time, and so on. The more leading zeros we require, the harder this process is. So it doesn't happen, yeah, the first time. Right? I pick a one, I hash it, and it doesn't work. So what I do is I go to two, and I hash it again, and I get a totally different hash, which maybe has a different number of leading zeros. And I go, well, does this work? No, okay. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. And I just keep churning away with these random numbers in this nonce field here, incorporating any transactions I've received in the meantime, until I get this kind of golden hash that I've been looking for, which is very, very small. So let's say 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, some sort of numbers at 1, 0, 1, 1, and something like that, right? Now, this is SHA-256 in the case of Bitcoin, so it's 256 bits long. Now, as soon as I've done that, I go, well, brilliant, I've got some Bitcoins. I transmit this to the network, and everyone sees this and goes, cool. And then they take this hash, and they put it in the next block and start mining on that one as well with new random numbers. So every time someone stumbles across a hash which is small enough, that's when they've mined the Bitcoin. Right? And so that's how the difficulty of a network has changed. You just change the threshold of number of zeros or size of your hash that you need to be below in order to be successful. Every couple of thousand blocks, the network will look at how long it took, and if like a bunch more miners have appeared, so it's actually starting to get a little bit too easy, they'll increase this difficulty, such that hopefully a Bitcoin is mined roughly every 10 minutes. Now, of course, this process is random, so it might be less, might be more, but on average. If a bunch of miners disappeared, suddenly it's taking 50 minutes to mine a Bitcoin. They'll just reduce this threshold so that you can mine that a little bit more easily. The number of Bitcoins that a miner is awarded is halved every so often as well. So I think, is it 12.5 at the moment? So I will have sort of plus 12.5 for Mike in here as sort of my benefit of being the miner. So this will only ever get actually put into the blockchain if I'm the one that finds this hash. Otherwise, unfortunately, it'll be someone else's name in here.
We've sat here and watched Beast churn through billions of passwords, hashes. How hard can it be to come up with this number?
As hard as they need it to be. You've got to think that for all the miners on Earth, at least a lot of them have got dedicated hardware, many trillions of hashes, and they're still only doing it every 10 minutes, right? It's not easy to do. Right? And they can just keep making this more difficult until it takes about 10 minutes. In some ways, you can't make the problem more easy by buying more and more hardware, because it will just make itself more difficult for you. For now, most of my contact with it is via a terminal, and I ask it to do things and it does them very, very fast. This particular server has 4 Titan X graphics cards in it. A Titan X is one of the foremost graphics cards. There are new